How many? We have studied about the strategy for design of goods and processes, right? We have discussed about the processes strategy, right? We have discussed about the location strategy, right? We have going to discuss now layout strategy. So actually, how many strategies that we are going to have or to study or to understand in order to fulfill the competitive advantages if we want to globalize our organization or our product or our services. How many?
10.
10. Betul, saya bagi 2. Apa saja? Kalau you mention, saya bagi tambah 2 lagi. Boleh?
Location, design, itu aja tahu.
We have study processes, right? Process strategies. Now, location, layout, human resources, extra, maintenance, yeah. So all of this we should learn, and then we total there are 10 strategies, yeah. So then we should understand, yeah, what is the decision, yeah, of these strategies that we want to make decision, yeah. Like in the location we have first started, right? So in which location that we want to choose by analyzing using the cost of acquire, right? Am I right? You check the design of good and processes. Yeah, we have a house of quality how to make a decision, right? So this is that we should understand, and then the later with the decision, so we can fulfill, yeah, the differentiation, yeah, the best product or goods or services, or we can reduce the cost. Then we reduce the under-added values, yeah, activities, and then we have the third one, the response. Yeah, response. So we should listen to the customer requirement, customer needs. Yeah. So then we can fulfill, yeah, competitive advantages. So then. We are ready for competition, and we are, hopefully we win the competition, right? Now let's see about the layout strategy, yeah. So actually, what is the objective, yeah, of the layout strategy? As we know, like illustration of the layout, like a McDonald's, yeah, Kentucky Fried Chicken. So you can see the difference between that kind of a restaurant layout with the traditional layout like My Mama or other traditional rumah makan Minang. You can see the difference, the layout. Then how attractive they are. So then how they can win the competition. So this is the illustration. Yes.
Ada orang nak masuk.
Yeah. Yeah. See, now McDonald's, yeah, you have the illustration. So in this case, there are 6 out of the 7 layout decision. It's an example. You can go to the McDonald's or KFC or California Fried Chicken, yeah. Just then you see the difference, the layout. So then how they are interested, yeah, how we are interested to come, yeah, to buy food, right? Fast food for example. So let me appear to you. So the importance of layout decision is to make, yeah, the effective and efficient layout. that will meet the requirement of the competitive advantage. So to make effective and efficient layout, so then will be fulfilling, yeah, fulfilling the competitive advantages requirement, yeah, like reduction of cost, yeah, and then yeah, especially reduction of cost, yeah, in this case. So we can see later that we can reduce the cost by changing the layout or design the layout. So to make effective and efficient the layout, so we should not make the layout or make the space useless. We should make this all space useful, yeah, and support, yeah, to the production. So in this layout design consideration, we have to consider about the utilization of space, yeah, as well as the equipment. We should not let the equipment idle. The equipment we buy as an asset, yeah, we should operate in the full, yeah, occupation, yeah, full operation, as well as people, yeah. We should not let the people to just relax and then not working properly. We should utilize the all resources, yeah, space, equipment, and people as optimal, as efficient and effective, as well as the flow. Yeah, the design of the layout should consider the flow. The flow of what? Information, materials, as well as people. Because the flow will be the cost. If longer flow, then the longer will be higher cost. Yeah, I have experience when design in the layout of a power plant, yeah, secondary power plant, yeah, how the turbine and the motor and then the space, yeah, and the spare part, yeah, should be a design. But it is easy. We can use the automatic computer. We just make the instruction, the computer will do. But in this like an organization, yeah, it's not so many department or sections, so then we can do manually, yeah, by ourselves. So then we can make the efficient and effective flow, efficient and effective utilization of resources, as well as, yeah, the layout design should be improve the morale of the people, the morale of the employees, as well as the saving, yeah, saving working condition. And then also the layout design, we should consider about the interaction between customer and the supplier, for example. And then the layout design also should consider about the flexibility. It's not fixed. Yeah? We should make flexible as possible. Yeah. Yeah. Without removing the efficient, the effectivity of the function, yeah, of the flow of the utilization. So that we also consider the flexibility in this case. So in this layout strategy, yeah, layout design strategy, so there are many types, depends on the environment of the organization, like the office type of the organization. So we have the office layout, also the retail layout, supermarket, right? We should consider the retail layout, warehouse, yeah, when we want to deposit our spare part, yeah, and other equipment, yeah, in the warehouse. So we should consider about the layout, the fixed position layout, where they on any equipment or processes, yeah, in the same position. Yeah. So how can we consider the efficient, the effective of the layout? And then the other is a processing oriented layout. So in this case, we should consider about the process, and also flow. Yeah. So that is because process and flow will consider the cost. Workshop layout and the product oriented layout. Yeah, it's a type of layout that we are going to see in general. So in the office layout, we should consider the grouping of worker, their equipment, and the worker for the same function. We will group in the same department, purchasing department, for example, information department, marketing department, operation department, etc. So this is the grouping of worker, and then how this is. The layout make this efficient and effective. So this is regarding the movement of the information is main distinction. See, for example, we can the relationship between the department, how important the relationship between the department. So we can assess. So then before we consider, before we following up the layout, so we should consider first the relationship between department and organization. Department such as accounting department, marketing department, operation department, graphic art, information technology, social media relations, launch area. Then we can identify to the class, for example, the absolutely necessary close between the department or between the section, or especially important or important, ordinary, okay, unimportant or not desirable. Let's see here, like accounting and marketing. Accounting and marketing. Yeah, it's a ordinary okay. Yeah, the department, the closeness between the two departments. What about the accounting and the operation? Yeah, the accounting, the operation want to buy something, we should go to accounting department or finance department. So this is absolutely necessary. Yeah, the closeness between accounting and operation. What about the marketing? Yeah, marketing also to the operation is very important. Marketing got the purchase order, for example, then will be passed to the operation department. So this is the absolutely necessary, the closeness between the two departments. Okay, and others. So we have operation and graphic art. Yeah, oh, this is only okay, the closeness. For example, launch area, or launch area and information technology. Is there any? This is unimportant, and there is no relationship. So this is the relationship chart before we put into the layout. Yeah, we want to design a new layout for an organization or new area or new place. Then we should consider about this one, and we should evaluate from the previous. For example, if we want to move to another place, okay. So this is the related to the layout design, in the office layout. This the office layout will be having three physical and social aspects like proximity, privacy, and permission. So this is. Office layout consideration. Now, the second About the retail layout, so we know, right? We have been experienced going to supermarket, right? And mall, for example. So this is a part of the retail layout. So the objective is to maximize profitability per square foot of floor space. Yeah, if we go to the mall, right? So the building, so every single of aisle there will be the shop there, or drink corner, for example. So this is a maximization of the square foot of floor space. Sales and profitability vary directly with the customer exposure. So this is a five helpful idea for supermarket layout. Yeah. Locate hydro items around the periphery of the store. See, in the supermarket, so in the periphery of the store, so there will be hydro items around there. So then the customer can be easily to see and then to choose what they like. Use prominent location for high imports and high margin items. Distribute power item to both sides of an aisle and disperse them to increase viewing of other items. See, so then in order to see all of the space can be seen easily. Yeah, where's the fashion book location? Yeah, for the elementary school, high school, university, so that we can see easily. Yeah, like in the supermarket, for example, there is the food, or kitchen set, and other items. Yeah, so we can see clearly from the entrance location. Okay. Use an aisles location. Yeah, so there will be use the aisles. Yeah, and aisles location with the putting by any goods or foods or equipment there.
Doctor. Doctor.
Yes.
Sorry
yes.
for interrupt. Someone want to enter this class. May you accept?
Okay.
Thank you, doctor.
Yeah. So this is of the the supermarket or store layout. So this is we can see the store layout. So we have the dairy, photo lab, check stand. In the middle there is the food. Food court, wine, beer, seafood, ethnic food, daily extras, bakery. So this is the layout. Yeah. So there you can see the different layout there for store, like for the Family Mart, for the 7-Eleven, and other store layout, the different layout. Giant. And many stores, you can go and then you can see the different, but typically they have the same layout. There's the food court, usually in the back, the front we have the any items that they sell, but they also they provide the corner for the restaurant, shop. I mean the coffee shop there. So this is the retail layout design. So the retail layout, the objective to maximize profitability per square foot of floor space. Yeah. So we should not let any single of the square foot of floor without any function, and then the we do not utilize the space. So we can, if we are as a manager in the mall, for example, so we can rent this space yet to the for a certain corner, yeah, for shop corner, yeah. So then they can get the profit or maximize the profit. The another layout, yeah, is the warehouse, yeah, the warehouse layouts. So if we consider about the inventory system, so the warehouse is very important. The objective is to find the optimum trade-off between handling cost and cost associated with the space. Yeah, so we should not utilize all space, yeah, for depositing the spare part, for example, or inventory or equipment. So maximize the total cube. So we should not let the space, yeah, blank without any function. Like yeah, all costs will be considered. All costs will cover the incoming transport. There will be cost. Storage, there will be cost. Finding and moving material also cost. Outgoing transport also cost. Equipment, people, material, yeah. Supervision, insurance, depreciation of the asset. This is also cost. So we should consider of this. And then we should not let any single space, yeah, without any function into the inventory or warehousing. Yeah. See, in this case, you see when we have a space here, so for putting the spare part, yeah, or important item, yeah, in the warehouse as an inventory, yeah, then we use the automatic storage and retrieval system, yeah, ASRS. Yeah. So this is you see using the forklift, yeah, like forklift or this ASRS actually, yeah, to storage or to retrieve the goods, yeah, or item, yeah, from this warehouse. And you can see the space here, yeah, from the bottom to the upper part, we should use the space for putting the item, yeah, in the warehouse. So we should not let any space, yeah, not function, yeah, in this warehouse space. Okay. The warehouse density tend to vary inversely with the number of different items stored. Yeah, this is using the ASRS. Yeah, storaging and the retrieving system item. There will be automation. Yeah, in this warehouse. Yeah, to make more efficient and effective the layout. And sometimes in the warehouse we use the cross docking. Yeah. Cross docking, yeah, we have material move directly from receiving, yeah, to the shipping, for example. Yeah. The receiving and shipping, so we have to cross docking. So this is the forklift here to bring the from the receiving and then to the outbounding. Also, we have a random stocking as well, yeah, along the efficient use of space. So in this typically require automatic identification system and effective information system. So the random stocking. Yeah. So this is the KITAS, yeah, maintain list of the open location, maintain accurate records, yeah, sequence item to minimize travel, pick time, combine packing orders, assign classes of item to particular areas. Yeah, so this is all using the automatic identification system. Yeah, you can use the barcode. Yeah, using the barcode so that we can identify the effective information where the item should be delivered. Yeah, so this is the very easy. Yeah, without any reading. Yeah, and seeing, yeah, inside of the barcode, for example. So using the barcode, so we can identify all of the information regarding the items. Yeah. So this is the use in the warehouse, as well as customizing. Yeah. The customizing is also just now using the barcode. Yeah. In the warehouse, will be using the labeling or the packaging, the barcode. Or we in the warehouse also we equip the repair. Yeah, the repair. If the spare part need the repair, and then we can repair. Yeah, before Doctor, using. Yeah.
Sorry for interrupting, but there's somebody who wants to enter the meeting.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah, the customizing. Also, yeah, at the warehouse also maybe equipped the assembly section for the component. Yeah, assembly of the component. Yeah, if we did before using to the for the operation the or production the department. Yeah, so at the warehouse the component will be assembly. Of course, you see this assembly section. Yeah, at the warehouse also can be customized. Also, as well as loading software. Yeah. So this is using customizing to make efficient and effective the warehouse as our inventory system. Yeah, and on the other hand, yeah, by reducing the inventory system, so we use the JIT, right, just in time. So we should not use the space or warehouse. So we use our supplier, yeah, to supply any spare part, yeah, in any time. And then we just call, make a call, yeah, the number of item, and then the when it should be delivered. Yeah, so they're using the just in time. But if we use the warehouse, then we should make more efficient, effective. And so then we will be reducing the cost. The fixed position layout, yeah. So the fixed position layout, so we use one space, yeah, yeah, in many function, in many process, yeah. Like you see in this case in the hospital, yeah, we have all gathered at the same location, yeah, the doctor, patient, yeah, using the surgery, the equipment, tools, yeah, and also the helper, yeah, and then equipment, the operation, the machine, so, yeah, and then the monitor of the heart, yeah, pulse. So this is the either one place. Product remains, yeah, in one place. Worker and equipment come to site. So this is all of the process, yeah, in the one place. So this is we call as a fixed position layout. Of course, this is where the doctor and then the equipment should be put. Yeah. So this is a already fixed, yeah, in the position. Doctor operated here. Yeah. Tool will be in the here, for example. So then the specialist doctor, the other doctor will help, yeah, the specialist doctor, yeah, and putting the tools here or in this location. It's not to other location. So this is a fixed position layout. Another layout is a process oriented layout. So, like machine and equipment are grouped together, yeah, into the in the one department, for example. So then the another department has a different machine and different equipment. So this is a process oriented layout. So in this case, the flexible and capable of handling a wide variety of products or services. Yeah. scheduling can be difficult and set up. So then the material handling and labor cost can be high. So then we can minimize or we can maximize the layout. So then we can reducing the cost as much as possible. This is an example of the process-oriented layout, like in the hospital. Just now, fixed oriented layout is for the in surgery, in the one place. But this is a process-oriented layout is in the hospital, for example. Yeah, the patient A has a broken leg, so they go to the ER triad rooms, and then go to the radiology, and then surgery, and then ER beds, and the pharmacy for the medicine, and then billing. So this is based on the broken leg patient. But another patient will be the erratic heart pacemaker will be different process. And we go to the triac room, and then surgery, and then go to the pharmacy for the medicine, and then go to the laboratory, and then bed, and then billing. So this is the process, the different with the patient with the different diseases, different problem. Broken leg or erratic heart pacemaker, so the process will be different. So this is a process-oriented layout. Now let's see example. Example of the arrangement of the work centers. So as to minimize the cost of material handling. In this example, the arrangement of the work centers based on the number of loads and distance loads. If the distance is longer, so this will be expensive. So then the load will be total total cost will be the number of load and the distance. If we bring two, for example, 1 meter and 10 meter different, right? So 1 meter, we bring two items, 1 meter. So this is easy to give to the another department. But if we, the distance will be 10 meter, then will be we walk and then bring this item, and then to the other department. So there will be cost will be can be double. So the cost, the total cost, the total cost will be depends. If we in the organization, the organization have a department, many department, J department, the number of department J, and then the total number of work centers, N, and then the XIJ is the number of routes. You move from department one to another department. So this is the number of load, like how many items to bring, two items, three items, four items, so the X. And then C is the cost of moving. Move a load between the department. The moving load, 1 meter and 2 meter and 10 meter will be different. Usually if this is brought by the staff, right? So a staff were moving only side by side door, to bring the item, will be different if the staff will bring to one department to another department with the different the location is far. So then, how can we calculate the cost? Calculate the cost, so then all of this will be the summation of the all of this possibility of the moving, yeah, of the cost, yeah, or load and moving. Yeah. So let's see the example. Arrange six departments. So we have the six department in a factory to minimize the material handling cost. Yeah, each department is 20 feet, and the building is 60 feet long and 40 feet wide. You can see here, this one. So we have six departments. Yeah, with the each department have a 20 feet area, yeah, square feet. Yeah. So assembly department, painting department, machine shop department, receiving department, shipping department, testing department. So this is the this is like a location, yeah, of the organization with the 60 feet length and 40 feet wide. Okay, then inside we have a department. Yeah, so the costs between department are different. Yeah, assembly department and painting department. Is there any load? Is there any moving there? So we have the metric. We have first we should get the construct from two metrics. From two metrics. This is from assembly to painting, for example. So this is the number of load per week. And this is per week is 50. Assembly to machine shop is 100. Assembly to receiving, no. Yeah, and assembly to shipping, no. Assembly to testing, 20. So this is the number of load per week. And then painting to machine shop, yeah, we have here given 30, the number of load per week. Okay, extra. So this is from two metrics. Yeah, so this is we have to analyze in the from two metrics. And we make the interdepartmental flow graph. Yeah, the flow graph. So from assembly department to the painting department. Right. There are 50. Load 50. Right. Painting to machine 30. So we can from the from two metric, yeah, from two metric. So we make the flow graph here. Okay, flow graph is the coming from the layout of the for example the layout of the organization, yeah, assembly to paint and to machine shop. Yeah, so then we make this, yeah, a flow graph, yeah, from one department to another department, and what is the load? Yeah, assembly to machine shop 1, 2, 3, 100 the load. Okay, so from this what is the cost? The cost one and two, 1, 2, 2 here, yeah. So 1, 2, 2, right. 1, 2, 2, 50. 50, the load is 50, yeah, $50. And then the assembly department to painting department, yeah, just side by side. So there is no additional cost. 1, 2, 3, yeah. 1, 2, 3, yeah. So the distance is far, yeah, double, yeah, from assembly department to the painting department, yeah, assembly department to machine department. So this is will be double, yeah, the distance, yeah. So this is not side by side, so they should move here. Yeah. So this is that we can have two times, yeah. So double the cost, yeah. So we have this C, or X, whatever, so for example the load is 50 and the C is a in this case is a 1 because this is side by side. And then if 1 2 3 1 2 3 assembly to machine, so X is a 200 and then C is 2 since this is the double, so that is 200. 1 2 6 1 2 6 assembly to testing, so this is a 20, the load is 20 but the distance is a double, so then we can have a 20 times 2 40, so then the and others the process, so then we can have the cost. The total cost is a $570. Based on this layout, okay. So then we can have the idea. We have the idea how can we reduce the cost when we change the location. We change the layout. I'm sorry. Not location. We change the layout. Any other idea? So what should we change the layout? Siapa yang boleh dapat, saya bagi 3 bonus point. For example. Tak ada yang boleh? Halo? Understand or not? So we have the layout, we have the 6 department. We have 1 2 3 4 5 6 department. And then we have the load, between the one department to department. Load means we should bring item, for example, so the load, depends of the requirement of the department. In this case, see that the load, assembly to machine 100, assembly to painting 50, painting to machine 30, painting to receiving 50, etc. So from this, for example, from the 3 department, we have the cost rate, the process cost rate. Am I right?
Yes, doctor.
Then, so how can you make them more efficient cost, or we can reduce the cost? Siapa boleh jawab, saya bagi 3 bonus point. Siapa boleh? Sebetulnya di berikutnya ada, tapi I want to make you understand. So how can we make changing the layout so that to make efficient? Siapa boleh jawab?
Letak machine shop, machine shop, tukar kepada painting.
Tukar dengan painting, kenapa?
Sebab assembly dengan machine shop lebih berkaitan.
Jadi, so it's very simple, right? Very easy, right? Very easy to see. Just because this the load is very high, but this is longer. Why don't you change? They're close each other. Am I right?
Yes.
Itu dia. Itu jawabannya. So let's see calculate what is the cost actually and we change. Now we change this one. Assembly and the machine close each other, right? So meaning that the assembly and painting changing. Painting at the left here and the assembly at the middle. So then, we can see here the cost will be reducing. Yeah, assembly to machine just now if we use the previous layout, then the cost will be 200, right? But this is a 30, usually previously is 30, and this is becoming 60, right? 60, yeah. But this is, but only increase 30, but when you put this assembly and machine shop is far each other, that will be 100 cost. Yeah. So then you can reduce the cost. So let's see the calculation. See, yeah, the cost will be 50, yeah, for 1 to 2, yeah, 1 to 2. So 1 to 2, so this is will be 50, and 1 to 3 previously as 200, this is only 100 because close each other. Okay, and then the. 1 to 6, yeah. 1 to 6, 20, yeah. 1 to 6, 20. Okay. Previously, 1 to 6 is a far, right? 40. So then, total, yeah. If we calculate total the cost, yeah, using this equation, so will be $480. So you can save, right? Berapa banyak? Cukup banyak, kan? So from 570 with the this design, layout this layout design, then we can change to this layout. You just changing the department location, the layout changing with the painting, just change, yeah, exchange, yeah, painting and the assembly department. Then you can save. How many? Yeah, 480 and 570. So you have a save $90. So this is important. This is important the layout. Okay. Any question about this?
No.
The purchase layout. Okay, understand semua ya. So I will give the I will give the group assignment, yeah, from now, so you can do the answer the assignment, yeah, by your using with your friend in the same group, yeah. You have read the group assign group the group, yeah. Group assignment, member, you have read, am I right?
Yes.
Yes, brother.
Okay, so I will give the this is group assignment. So this is will be 15% the group assignment. Yeah. So if you have no you have to if you do not understand this, please let me know. Yeah, semua udah paham. So we will use this process layout. Design, ya, proses layout the design. Siapa yang tak paham sini? Okay, ya. So hopefully we will be full mark. But this is a little bit, I mean not so complicated. But you should do, you should discuss with your member, and then you answer the assignment. Is that okay?
Okay, Doctor.
Okay, so today class, so I will end this. Yeah, I think this is enough. So I will continue. Yeah, on Thursday. Yeah, with the cell layout and the others. Okay. If you have no question, so I will end. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Waalaikumsalam,
Dokter. Thank you, Dokter.
Thank you, Dokter.
Thank you, Dokter.
Okay.
Okay.